Children, it is a next part of the chapter Acids, Bases and Salts. Now let us write the answer to the in-text questions. Children, you go through the chapter Acids, Bases and Salts in the textbook. Then you will get some in-text questions. In the first set of in-text questions, there is one question. What is that question? You have been provided with three test tubes. One of them contains distilled water and the other two contain an acidic solution and basic solution respectively. If you are given only red litmus paper, how will you identify the contents of each test tube? Children, here three test tubes are given and one of them contains distilled water and the other two contains acidic solution and basic solutions, but you don't know in which test tube distilled water is there, acid solution is there and basic solution is there. Here we have to identify the contents of each test tube. Here you know that which indicator is given here. You are given only red litmus paper. By using that red litmus paper, we have to identify the content of the test tube. That is, which one is acid, which one is base and which is the distilled water. You know that in distilled water, there is no change in the color of the litmus paper. It remains same. And in acid solution, the color of the litmus is red. If there is blue litmus, it changes into red. Similarly, if there is bases in the test tube, red litmus turns to blue. By using this property of the indicator, we have to identify the contents of each test tube. So here what you are going to do, divide the red litmus paper in three parts. Here divide the red litmus paper in three parts and dip each part in three test tubes. Dip each red part in the test tube A, test tube B, test tube C. The test tube in which red litmus paper turns blue contains basic solutions. So here red litmus turns to blue, then you can identify that solution is basic solution. And the blue litmus paper so obtained is dipped into the remaining two solutions. Here, what you have to do, remove that blue litmus and two test tubes are remaining. As the red litmus turns blue, that is the base. So then remove that litmus paper which is blue in color and dip in the other two test tube. Then you can identify the acid which turns blue litmus into red. The blue litmus paper so obtained is to be dipped into the remaining two solutions. The one which turns blue litmus paper red again is an acidic solution. First one, you identified base. Next, you identified acid. The solution in which blue litmus is turned into red is the acid. Then third one, in which the red litmus remains same. There is no any change in the color. The third tube in which there is no change of color contains water. In this way, you identified the distilled water, acidic solution and basic solution. Now let us write the answer here. Write the answer to the question. So you write that, divide the red litmus paper in three parts. Red litmus paper in three parts and dip each part in three test tubes and dip each part in three test tubes. The test tube in which red litmus paper turns blue. The test tube in which red litmus paper turns blue. Contains basic solutions. So in the first step we have done this. Next you got the basic solution, and in the third step what you have to do, the blue litmus paper so obtained is the blue litmus paper so obtained is dipped into the remaining two solutions. Then the step 4, the one which turns blue litmus paper, the one which turns blue litmus paper red again is acidic solution. The third tube in which there is no change of color contains water. Is distilled water. Here this is the step 1. You write step 1, step 2, step 3 and step 4. Here that litmus paper is divided into 3 parts and dip each part in each test tube. And the test tube in which red litmus turns blue contains basic solution. The blue litmus so obtained is dipped into the remaining two solutions. The one which turns blue litmus paper red again is acidic solution. In this way you got base and acid. And the third tube in which no change of color is distilled water. In the second set of in-text questions there are 3 questions. First one is, why should curd and sour substances not be kept in brass and copper vessels? Second one, which gas is usually liberated when an acid reacts with a metal? Illustrate with an example. How will you test for the presence of this gas? Next, third question, metal compound A reacts with dilute hydrochloric acid to produce effervescence. The gas evolved extinguishes a burning candle. Write a balanced chemical equation for the reaction if one of the compounds formed is calcium chloride. Now let us discuss the answer one by one. First one, why should curd and sour substances not be kept in brass and copper vessels? Curd and sour substances are acidic and acids react with brass and copper, and so are not kept in brass and copper vessels. Poisonous metal compounds will be formed. Then you write the answer. Curd 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 and other sour substances. Curd and other sour substances have acids. Have acids which can react with the metals of the vessel to form poisonous metal compound. Which can cause food poisoning and damage our health. This is the answer to this question. Then you take the second question. Which gas is usually liberated when an acid reacts with a metal? Illustrate with an example. How will you test for the presence of this gas? Here, which gas is usually liberated when an acid reacts with a metal? You know that is hydrogen. Illustrate with an example. How will you test for the presence of this gas? So what is the gas liberated here? H2 gas when an acid reacts with metal. To illustrate with an example, children, you write that set up an apparatus as shown in the figure. Here you draw the figure. Take some zinc granules in the test tube. Add about 5 ml dilute hydrochloric acid or sulfuric acid slowly. So the reaction between zinc and hydrochloric acid starts and hydrogen gas is evolved. And there is one more question. How will you test for the presence of this gas? Test for H2 gas. H2 gas is not soluble in water. When passed through soap solution, it gets trapped into bubbles which turn with explosion. So you write the answer. Here the first part question. Which gas is usually liberated? So write H2 gas is liberated when acid reacts with metal. H2 means hydrogen. Hydrogen, that is H2, its molecular formula is H2. One molecule of hydrogen containing two atoms of hydrogen. So write hydrogen gas is liberated when acid reacts with metal. The next one, that is for illustration. Here it is there, illustrate with an example. So you write illustration So we write the illustration, set up an apparatus as shown in the figure. Set up an apparatus as shown in the figure. Take some zinc granules. Take some zinc granules in the test tube. Add 5 ml dilute hydrochloric acid or sulfuric acid. Dilute hydrochloric acid or write sulfuric acid. Slowly. Soon the reaction between zinc and hydrochloric acid starts and hydrogen gas is liberated. So write, soon the reaction between zinc and hydrochloric acid. Starts and hydrogen gas is evolved. So write the chemical reaction Zn zinc HCl gives ZnCl2 plus H2. Here Cl2 is there, H2 is there. So you write 2HCl. Zn one more atom, Zn one atom. So now it is balanced. Now again here there is a question, how will you test for the presence of this gas? So you take test for H2 gas. Test for H2 gas. So what is the test? H2 gas is not soluble in water. When passed through soap solution, it gets trapped into bubbles with burns, which burns with explosion. So you write, pass the gas being evolved through the soap solution. Bring a burning candle near a gas filled with soap bubble. So take near a gas filled soap bubble. Here soap bubble is filled with H2S. The gas present in the soap bubble burns with pop sound. gas present in the soap bubble burns with a pop sound. In this way, you can test the hydrogen gas which is liberated. Next, you take the third question. Metal compound A reacts with dilute hydrochloric acid to produce effervescence. The gas evolved extinguishes a burning candle. Write a balanced chemical equation for the reaction if one of the compounds formed is calcium chloride. Here, what is the answer for the question? The end product is calcium chloride. Here the end product is calcium chloride. And the gas formed, gas evolved is that extinguishes the burning candle. That is the carbon dioxide. And the metal compound A must be calcium carbonate. Here, what is the metal compound A? That is the carbonate, calcium carbonate. And hydrochloric acid is given, that is dilute hydrochloric acid. When dilute hydrochloric acid reacts with calcium carbonate, that is the compound A, carbon dioxide will be liberated and calcium chloride, the salt is also formed. So how will you write the chemical reaction here? So you write, since the end product is calcium chloride and the gas formed extinguishes a burning candle, it is CO2 and the compound is calcium carbonate. So you write the answer. Since the end product is calcium chloride and the gas formed extinguishes a burning candle. So the gas is CO2. CO2 is carbon dioxide. And the compound A is, here it is given that metal compound. Metal compound A is calcium carbonate. Metal compound A must be calcium carbonate. That is CaCO3. Here, to write the balanced chemical equation, you must know the reactants. Without knowing the reactants and products, it is not possible to write the chemical equation. So here the end products are given, calcium carbonate, and the gas formed extinguishes a burning candle means it must be carbon dioxide. So you got the product here, CO2 and calcium chloride. Then you can guess that the metal compound must be calcium carbonate. So you write, hence the reaction. Hence the reaction is reaction between what and what? Calcium carbonate and hydrochloric acid. hydrochloric acid. So write CaCO3 plus HCl gives end product is calcium chloride, and also CO2 is there, and there must be H2O. So it is calcium chloride. So it is what? This is calcium carbonate. Then here you have to balance the equation. Ca is there, here Cl2 is there, H2 is there. So you can write here 2 and O3. O3 means O2 plus O becomes O3. Then carbon single is there, calcium also single. So all atoms are balanced. So you got a balanced chemical equation. CaCO3 reacts with hydrochloric acid, gives calcium chloride, CO2 together with water. That is the chemical reaction which is balanced according to the given situation. Now you take the next set of in-text questions. Here there are 6 questions. And what is that first question? Why do HCl, HNO3, etc. show acidic characters in aqueous solutions, while solutions of compound like alcohol and glucose do not show acidic characters? Second question, why does an aqueous solution of an acid conduct electricity? Third question, why does dry HCl gas not change the color of the dry litmus paper? While diluting an acid, why is it recommended that the acid should be added to water and not water to the acid? Now the fifth question, how is the concentration of hydronium ions H3O+ affected when a solution of an acid is diluted? Sixth question, how is the concentration of hydroxide ion OH- affected when excess base is dissolved in a solution of sodium hydroxide? Now let us take the question one by one and write the answer. So the first question, what is that question? Why do HCl, HNO3, etc. show acidic characters in aqueous solutions, while solutions of compound like alcohol, glucose do not show acidic characters? Here we observed the difference between the HCl, NO3, etc. It means other compounds which are having hydrogen. Even though they are having hydrogen, they are not acids. And you know the reason that when acids are dissolved in water, H+ ions in aqueous solution are responsible for acidic character. When acids are dissolved in water, they dissociate into ions. HCl, HNO3, etc. generate H+ ions in water. But these alcohol and glucose, they do not produce ions. So they do not conduct electricity, as there is no formation of ions. So you write that H+ ions in aqueous solutions are responsible for acidic character. Answer, you write H+ ions in the aqueous solutions are responsible for acidic character. HCl, HNO3, etc. generate H plus ions in water. H plus ions in water and show acidic characters in aqueous solution. And show acidic characters in aqueous solutions, but alcohol take it as C2H5OH ethyl alcohol and glucose. That is C6H12O6. Do not produce H plus ions in water. So they do not show acidic character. Then second question, why does an aqueous solution of an acid conduct electricity? To conduct the electricity in the solution, ions must be there. When acid is dissolved in water, ions will be formed. Due to presence of ions, the solution conducts electricity. Acids, when added to water, forming an aqueous solution, split into ions. Due to presence of ions, the solution conducts electricity. So you write, acids gives ion. So write the answer that acids give ions in aqueous solution. Due to presence of ions, aqueous solution of an acid conducts electricity. Then you take next one. Why does dry HCl gas not change the color of the dry litmus? Color of litmus paper is changed by the hydrogen ions. HCl gas does not contain H plus ions. It is only in aqueous solution that an acid dissociates into ions. Since in this case, neither HCl is an aqueous form nor litmus paper is, the color of litmus paper does not change. Here, litmus is dry and HCl is also dry. To give the color, either litmus must be wet or it must be HCl solution. So, to form the ion, you must have the aqueous solution of HCl gas or wet litmus paper. Then only it is having the characters of changing the color. So you take dry HCl gas does not generate S plus ions. So you write the answer. Dry HCl gas does not generate H plus ion. H plus ions, and hence does not change the color of dry litmus paper. And hence does not change the color of dry litmus paper. The color of litmus paper is changed by the hydrogen ions, but HCl gas does not contain H plus ions. It is only in aqueous solution, you write. It is only in aqueous solution that an acid generates ions. But here HCl and litmus both are dry. With wet litmus also, dry HCl can give the acidic property that the litmus can change the color of the blue litmus. But here both are dry means there is no change in the color of the litmus paper. Now you take the fourth question. While diluting an acid, why is it recommended that the acid should be added to water and not water to the acid? When an acid is mixed with water, there is evolution of large amount of heat. Therefore, acid is slowly added to water. If water is added to acid, it might spill on the body and clothes due to explosion and evolution of sudden and large amount of heat. So, water is not to be added to acid. Then you write the answer. When an acid is, so write the answer. When an acid is mixed with water, there is evolution of large amount of heat. There is evolution of large amount of heat. Therefore, acid is slowly added to water. Acid is slowly added to water. If water is added to acid, if water is added to acid, it might spill on the body and clothes. Due to explosion and evolution of sudden and large amount of heat. Then fifth question, how is the concentration of hydronium ion H3O plus ion affected when a solution of an acid is diluted? When a given amount of an acid is added to water, there are a fixed number of hydronium ions per unit volume of the solution. On dilution, the number of hydronium ions per unit volume decreases and concentration of hydronium ion decreases. Number of hydronium ion per unit volume decreases and the concentration of hydronium ion decreases. That is about the concentration of hydronium ions affected when a solution of an acid is diluted. Now you write the answer. Hydronium ions per unit volume of the solution. On dilution, the number of hydronium ions per unit volume decreases and concentration of hydronium ion decreases. Concentration of hydronium ion decreases. This is the answer for the given question. Now you take the next question, sixth question. How is the concentration of hydroxide ions OH minus ion affected when excess bases is dissolved in a solution of sodium hydroxide? The concentration of hydroxide ions will increase when excess bases dissolved in a solution of sodium hydroxide because the amount of hydroxide ions per unit volume increases. This happens only when base added dissolves in water. If the base is not soluble in water, the concentration of hydroxide ions remains constant. Here, what is the question? How is the concentration of hydroxide ions affected when excess base is dissolved in a solution of hydroxide? Here, that is in the reverse manner as in the acid. The concentration of the hydroxide ion goes on increases as excess base is dissolved in a solution of sodium hydroxide. Write the answer that the concentration of hydroxide ions will increase when excess base is dissolved in a solution of sodium hydroxide. Sodium hydroxide, because the amount of hydroxide ions, per unit volume increases. This happens only when base added dissolves in water. So write this much only. What happens here? Amount of hydroxide ion per unit volume increases.